Hi, I'm Felicia.
And I'm Giancarlo. Got my off guard there. Go ahead.
And this is our preview of...
Cauldron.
A board game of competitive alchemy. Chemistry.
Yeah, baby. We say that for different reasons.
I really enjoy... If the people are watching out there who made this game, keep this image.
Very cool. Mm-hmm. It is. It's a very cool art.
He's wearing the Breaking Bad.
Which I finally finished. Started and finished good? In 2 weeks. It's really good.
Cauldron.
Wow, you do that very well, Witch. In Cauldron, you play as a mythical character on the quest to master the arcane power of potion making. Let's take a look at components and setup. Each player will choose a character card and get that card with its token. This token is then placed on the magic tracker on spot number 2. To create the field, take enough tiles from each of the types to equal the number of players plus 1. Then, place them to create a random field in the middle of the table. With the leftover tiles, make stacks near the board. Shuffle each deck of cards and place them for easy reach for all players. This deck includes potions, spells, and omens. Each player now receives one easy basic potion card, a basic potion card, and 2 basic spell cards. Spell cards are kept secret as potions are set face up in front of you. You're now ready to start your quest to become the Grand Infusionist.
The game is played in 2 seasons, the harvest season and the market season. The harvest season starts with flipping over an omen card. This is visible to all players and is read out loud. These affect the current harvest season. Then you must populate the board with 1 ingredient matching each tile. Some omen cards might affect this number. Now each player will roll a die to see the turn order for this round. Play now goes around the table with players taking 1 action each until all ingredients have been harvested from the board. Let's take a look at these actions in detail.
You can harvest an ingredient from one of the tiles from the board. This is called a harvest action. You can attempt to steal an ingredient from another player by rolling a die. The steal is successful if you roll 4 or higher. If not, then you wasted an action. This is the steal action. You can brew a potion if you have the ingredients for it. If you do, discard the ingredients, but not the card, and gain the number of magic points indicated. The question mark means you can use any ingredient. If a card has the word quick on it, it does not count as an action, and you can play or do as many of these as you want on your turn. Other quick actions include casting a spell card or moving ingredients you own to a safe location in your cellar, which we'll explain later. Play keeps going around the table, and when the last ingredient is taken from the board, the end of the harvest season happens. Here, all ingredients not in the cellar go bad and are discarded. And the next phase is the market season.
During this phase, you get to buy stuff using your magic points from your track. You can buy a field for 3 magic points, which gets you 1 ingredient from that type, and you get to add the tile on the board adjacent to at least 2 other tiles. For 1 magic point, you can buy a basic spell card and add it to your hand. For 3 points, you can buy an advanced spell. To buy potions, the cost will vary according to the amount of potions you currently have in front of you. To buy a basic potion, it costs the same amount as the number of basic potions you own. So if you own 2, it costs 2 for a new one. To buy an advanced potion, it costs the same number of any potion you have plus 2. The magic track has special powers that unlock as the play goes on. Finally, you can buy a cellar for 3 magic points for this cellar, and 4 to buy a second one. You can only have 2 max. These cellars are good to keep your ingredients from being stolen or rotting at the end of the harvest season. Once each player has made 1 purchase or passed, the next harvest season begins and a new round is started. When a player reaches 35 magic points, they win and are the Great Infusionist. The game comes with alternative rules, which allows for more quicker and more strategic gameplay. If you like potion brewing games, resource management, and stealing from your friends, then you should go check out Cauldron. Thanks for watching our preview, and remember, if you like it, back it.